Okay, dear participants, let's continue our colloquium. The last session, software engineering in different fields. It is second session under this title. Moderator, it's me, Nikolai Shilov from Innopolis University. Nice to see all of you. The first speaker, Fyodor Chemashkin, Kubernetes operators as a control system for cloud native applications. Fyodor, are you here?
Yeah, hi everyone, I'm here.
Do I pronounce your family name correctly?
No, but it was funny.
please pronounce as it should be. Sorry that I made mistake.
Yeah, no problem. Chemashkin.
Chemashkin.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you for kind excuse. Please go ahead. Basically, you have 20 minutes and I will be strict, because you know, sure. Just Andrei a few minutes ago mentioned that we should finish at 4. Please.
Sure.
Okay.
Do you see?
Yes, I can see and they can hear.
Okay, thank you very much. So, hi everyone, my name is Fyodor Chemashkin. I'm a student of High School of Software Engineering at St. Petersburg, Peter of Grace and Petersburg Polytechnical University. Today with Pavel Dmitriyevich Drobintsev, we want to present our work about Kubernetes operators and cloud native applications and control family applications for them. So there are a lot of ways to migrate traditional application to the cloud. So it's like replacing, creating new one, reusing some services from cloud providers, some refactoring, replatforming. It means moving from one, for example, from one virtualization platform to another, rehosting from one cloud to another, from VMs to cloud. And just very funny option to migrate to cloud is retire application. So make it end of life and just create new one. And replacing with cloud native application can be the best option for some traditional application, because it leads to leveraging all features from cloud, from modern cloud providers. So cloud native application are executed in unpredictable environments, and application requirements can be changed in runtime depending on customer needs or some environment problems or some environment distractions. And control theory can be used to address all of these issues. There are some papers about that. So there are papers that contain possible ways to apply control theory in software engineering. In our work, we have started to research cloud native application, cloud native architecture, and their adaptive properties. And this paper is a research in progress paper. And our main goals are to describe cloud native application architecture and create a mapping between regular control theory terms and Kubernetes operators. Cloud native architecture is defined by using control theoretic and model-based approaches. This architecture has the following principle: virtualization, service orientation, uncertainty, and adaptivity. Patterns implement these principles for templates that can be used in multiple applications. So it's microservices, models at runtime, and control-based feedback loop. These principles and patterns allow creating a self-adaptive software systems. Self-adaptive systems are necessary to use to carry out changing requirements in unstable environments like cloud and maintain required performance from these applications. Cloud Native Computing Foundation is a special foundation that created by Linux Foundation. It's a foundation created to help evaluate and make production-ready cloud-native technologies in open-source model and vendor-neutral ecosystem. And they have technical oversight committee, and they have definition of cloud-native. And this definition contains key properties for cloud-native applications. its containerization, microservices architecture, and usage of immutable infrastructure. And based off these properties, we can conclude that cloud native application is a containerized, microservice-based, and dynamically managed application by some orchestration. Also, there are a lot of academia definitions. One of them you can see on this slide. So a cloud native application is a distributed, elastic, and horizontal scalable system composed of microservices, which is a late state in a minimum of stateful components. The application each self-contained deployment unit of that application is designed according to the cloud-focused design patterns and operated on a self-service elastic platform. So we can conclude that definition from industry and definition from academia is pretty similar. Kubernetes is de facto industry standard in container orchestration for dynamically dynamically changed application. Kubernetes is open source software presented by Google and has functionality for automatic deployment applications, scaling them, and control of containerized application. Kubernetes principle, so Kubernetes is a big system. It has a lot of components, but its principle and its essence can be described in one picture. In this figure, resources are like kind of building blocks. Resources have their own controllers, which implement a control loop that watches for these resources. Sometimes control loop in Kubernetes ecosystems is called as a reconciliation loop. Everything that happens in Kubernetes with applications that run inside of it, it goes to event stream, and event stream is a append-only log system, and some controllers can read. All controllers can read from them and make some actions to control these applications. And also, we can say that Kubernetes is not used for creating a cloud native application and using and leveraging all features from cloud native architecture, but also it uses this architecture, and Kubernetes itself is a cloud native application. Kubernetes has seven accession points, CLI, API clients, custom resources, etc. Complex stateful application require deep integration with Kubernetes. Kubernetes allow us to create a new custom resources and custom controller. This functionality has allowed to create a new type of software that was called Kubernetes operators. Kubernetes operator is a combination of custom resources and custom controllers that encode domain-specific knowledge for application. Operators were represented in Corio's white paper, Corio's company in their white paper that called Introducing Operators, Putting Operational Knowledge into Software. And there was a definition of operators. An operator is an application-specific controller that extends the Kubernetes API to create, configure, and manage instances of complex stateful application. It builds upon the basic Kubernetes resource and controller concept that include domain or application-specific knowledge to automate common tasks. The operator pattern is an implementation of controller pattern in Kubernetes with some application-specific knowledge. The controller pattern has much greater adaptation both in cloud native architecture and in simple and traditional software without any specific knowledge. These figures show how the controller pattern works. It reads the actual state of a resource from the API server, change the state of using CRUD operations, and update information about the state in the API server. And this loop can be described here as a control loop or in Kubernetes term as a reconciliation. And this loop is infinite by its nature. A control loop is also a non-terminated loop that regulates where the system works. So we have controller, we have controller output, we have some D-strings, we have controlled variable, and we have a plant. And well, this system can be described as a system of two equations. But if we go to operators, the system with changes in software, and we can describe, we can model as this system of equations, and on figure there is a replacement of control system to operators, but in fact still control systems, and in fact still the same terms and same same mathematical equations and the same matrix. Operator as a reconciliation loop or control loop work. We can describe it by pseudo code. So this function contains implementation of this control loop. So we periodically monitor some resources. In our case, if a change occurs or something go wrong, there are some differings. This controller or our operator, it sends a request to this server, and our controller try to modify somehow system state to become to make this system healthy again. For example, if there are some failures, and we try to make our system work in order to follow our requirements. So if we talk about apply control theory to Kubernetes operators, so in control theory we have a plant. So it's, in control theory it's just like some car, some plants, some ships, and in terms of Kubernetes operator, plant is a complex stateful application, so it's not a physical object or Kubernetes physical object, it's a software. And control system is a Kubernetes operator for them. So for example, we have Postgres operation in publicly available, and it managed Postgres database. We have Confluent operator. It managed a Confluent streaming platform that is based on Kafka. We have Provega operator that creates and controls Provega streaming storage, which is part of enterprise solution called Dell EMC streaming data platform. During the design and verification of control system, it's necessary to check key properties of control systems from like traditional control theory application is stability, controllability, observability. These properties can be considered from Kubernetes operators perspective too. So we have a system, we have some equations, stability is a property of control systems return to a given or close to its operating mode after any disturbance. Stability has different definition for both linear and non-linear systems. Lyapunov stability and some other criteria are used in regular control theory for such cases. And there are some papers with proposed methods to transfer these criteria to software. For applications that managed by operators, these distributants that hidden in matrix A can be like node failure, network glitches, restart of application instances, and operators that we described above, so Kafka operator, Provega operator, we can cope with perturbation and work with them. Another important property is controllability. This property show the ability to transfer the system from one state to another. So this is one of the mandatory steps in the synthesis of control systems. To prove controllability, we can use the controllability criteria, which states that a linear system is completely controllable if the rank of a controllability matrix is n. For Kubernetes operators, it means that application, the system that we try to model, it should be able to move a software system from one state to another. So, for example, from one failure state to some of healthy state or from like healthy state to some upgrading state and back to normal one. Observability is a property that shows whatever is possible to completely restore information about the state of the system at the exit. It's necessary to have information about the current state of system, but modeled as in our equation as x from t, and in each moment of time. The measurable and observable output variables we also have in our system. To prove observability, we can use the observability criteria, which states that a linear system is completely observable if the rank of observability matrix is n. Reconciliation loop in operators, or we can call it as control loop, use this property to achieve control goals. Operators have only output information during their work and during their runtime, so we can it can see only output state of system, and based on this information, operators should perform some actions to achieve control goals. What was done during synthesis of controller and creating of operators. So our future work is continue to research Kubernetes operators. There are a lot of operators are created, and we can research them and create some. So there are a lot of topics to research, and these topics are very interesting because there are interesting combination of academia experience and industry experience. We want to create an example of how to apply control theory, its methods, criteria and steps for designing a real controller for some complex stateful application. We want also create a mathematical adaptation of key properties of control systems, observability, controllability. We want to have some instructions, guides for developers, how we can check them during their work, and develop some recommendation for developers, how they can develop their operators in industry for with using some control theory laws and properties to achieve better performance and better reliability. So thank you for your attention. I will be glad to answer to all of your questions.
Thank you, Fyodor, very much. Any questions, please? You can raise your hand or just unmute your microphone. Any questions?
I have a short questions. What do you think about domain, boundary of domain of applicability of your approach?
I think it can be decided by developers, but from my point of view, so if you have like an application that very simple, it's stateless, so it's not necessary to create some complex logic to manage it. If you have complex stateful application like database, storage system, streaming platform, you should for running it in Kubernetes, you have to develop operator, because there are a lot of cases that can go wrong, and you should create operator. And if you have operator, because in fact it's a control system from control theory, you can use our approach, and you can try to create to apply some mathematical steps, use some proven laws to create a better application and give to your user best experience.
The same questions. Could you provide some example where your approach isn't applicable?
We can like say that it's stateless applications. Any stateless applications in containerized deployment.
More questions, please. If there are no more questions, I would like to ask one more question. May I ask, dear Fyodor?
Just
a short question. Your title assumes that there can be other approach to control to design control system for cloud native applications, but it seems to me that you did not mention any other approach than Kubernetes. Do you know or do you mind any other approach? Alternatives, please.
Yeah, very good question. Maybe I wasn't very clear. So we have like cloud native applications. We have like stateful applications. We have stateful cloud native application, and usually they run in Kubernetes. And in Kubernetes, there are a lot of ways to deploy applications. But for manage them like end to end, there are only operators. Mm-hmm. So, I mentioned like Pravega operator, Kafka operator, mm-hmm. Postgres operator. So this application are very complex. They are stateful and they create operators for managing their application in Kubernetes. Mm-hmm. So based on this and a lot of examples from industry, I can say that there are no way to manage complex stateful application in Kubernetes or like cloud or some cloud environments. Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much indeed, because it is very useful. Now I know the answer. Thank you. Thank you. Let's thank Fyodor for his presentation. And let's turn.
Thank you for your questions.
Let's turn to the second presentation of our session. This time, Evgenia Rezidinova, also from Petersburg Polytechnical University, is going to present a talk on developing a training program by the method of interval repetition. Correct? Evgenia, are you here? Uh-huh. Evgenia is not here yet. Honestly, it is her right to be later because we are ahead of time. Mm-hmm. No, Evgenia. Let's check. Of course, we can push forward the last talk if Evgenia is still not here. Yisu Ong, are you here?
Yes, I'm here.
Since there are no presenters of the second talk, mind if you will present right now? Sorry for this swap, but well.
It's okay.
Please, then we switch to the last, maybe the last, but maybe not the last. Maybe Evgenia will appear, will show later. So, Yesua Ong is going to present the artificial neural network for solving the classification problem with domain constraints. Please, you have 20 minutes.
Okay.
Okay, I see your screen, but not yet presentation, just your, okay, perfect.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm very glad to have this chance to present my paper. Before I start my presentation, let me introduce myself. My name is Jietu Ang from Myanmar. I'm now studying in Moscow Power Engineering Institute. Today, I will share my research with you. And the title of my presentation is the artificial neural network for solving the classification problem with domain constraints. Firstly, the purpose of my work is to replace the mathematical model with a neural network. Thus, it is necessary to analyze the neural network architectures and choose the most suitable one for solving this problem. Normalize the original data, find which neural network will provide a more accurate prediction of the result, evaluate the accuracy of the neural network. The neural network is a universal model as it is able to approximate any surface. The corresponding theorem was formulated in 1957 by Andrei Kolmogorov theorem. Every continuous function of X given on a unique keyboard, the dimensional space is representative as in following equation. One, to solve the feature scaling problem, we can use the following formula, equation two, which must be applied for each vector that is used in training the model. to determine the neural network architectures applicable to the construction of a regression model, the possibility of using different types of networks in different classes of problems was analyzed. The Hopfield network, contour propagation network, gradient basis network, multilayer perceptron, bidirectional associative memory, Hamming network, probabilistic network, adaptive resonance network were considered. A multilayer neural network consists of several layers. Each layer consists of neurons. A two-layer neural network is shown in figure one. By the learning rate, we can judge the correspondence of the sample and the neural network as shown in figure two. If the neural network is too complex, it will quickly retrain. As for example, the yellow line shows. If the sample is complex or very noisy for the neural network, the neural network will learn slowly as shown by the blue line. If the sample complexity corresponds to the neural network, then most likely we will see a red line, a good learning rate. It is important to keep track of the difference between the values of the error fashion in training and in control. The difference should not be significant. If it is large, it means that the neural network has been restrained and its complexity should be changed. In this slide, number six, seven, and eight, we compare the neural networks. These figures show the results of three models, neuron, perceptron, and multilayer perceptron. Judging by the graphs, we can conclude that the multilayer perceptron finds a solution well in comparison with simpler models. The neuron and perceptron models give rather poor results, and they are also prone to falling into the local minima of the error questionnaire. So the model may stop learning. For a more detailed analysis of the architecture, it is necessary to consider the multilayer perceptron graph closer. For dependent variable liquid at about 100 airport, the values of the test and train loss intercept are most likely in this case. It is worth finishing training the model. On the 100th airport of the training and test, the loss is approximately 0.05, which is a fairly good result. For dependent variable cost, training can be stopped at about 10 approaches And most likely the model is too complex since there are gems in the graph. On the 100 average of train and test, the loss is approximately 0.1, which is a bad result. For the variable water cut, at about 250 approaches, get the best result. The variable is predicted quite well. MSE is about 0.002. After that, we have continued to analyze Madilia perceptron. The architecture of Madilia perceptron is as follows. We will use a loss version optimizer at the number of approaches 2000, test sample 0.1 of the total. A batch normalization was used to make the model learn faster, and the dropout technique was used to control overfitting. In this course of numerous experiments with the model, it turned out that the complexity of the model does not solve the regression problem better. And when used in real time, a complex model may simple and not have time to calculate focus or failures due to the long execution time. The graphs in this slide show the predictions of the training sample. The graphs in this slide show the predictions of the testing sample. The symbols are similar. The model produces a good results on the training sample, relatively good, since zeros are not detected in fact. A very good water cut schedule for training. However, for the test data, the result is unacceptable. The model may not be able to predict three values at the same time. It may be worth considering separate model for water cut, liquid, and gas. Also, the test data is quite complex, so the error is so big. Finally, I will conclude my research. As a result of my research, it was found that the best solution to this problem is provided by a Madilia perceptron. The network of radial basis fashion gives us approximately the same result for the MSE metric. However, judging by the display of results on the graph with real values, the results were worse for each dependent variable. The best results were obtained for the dependent variable, water cut, most likely due to the fact that this variable does not have zero values. It is necessary to change the approach for solving the problem since all three dependent variables in this study also depend on each other. Thus, it is necessary to find not three models for solving each problem, but one model, for example, a Madilia perceptron with three outputs in each of which a dependent variable will be predicted. That's all of my presentation. Thank you for your attention and listening to my presentation.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much indeed. Questions, please. Show your presentation, because people may ask questions about your presentation. Sorry. Thank you. Okay, please, questions.
Please show first title slide.
Sorry?
Please show the very first slide.
First slide.
The very first, all right, title.
So my question, You specifically focused on neural network technology, but in fact, in this area, they exist and other approaches. Why you didn't consider other alternative approaches? I mean, for example, approach of Professor Alexander Zhdanov, automatic adaptive control. So did you saw something about this works?
Sorry, I don't understand your question.
I asked about comparison with alternative approach on not only neural networks for this kind of problems. Why did you restricted your investigation only by neural networks? Neural networks. Why?
Because my PhD thesis is depend on neural network. So I'm trying to research with the neural network for solving the classification problem.
More questions, please.
Yeah, I have a question. Can you tell us something about the data set that you're using? What was the amount of zeros? How you filtered them? And maybe the distribution of the target variable?
There are many data sets in my research. For example, flow velocity and gas content of the flow and sound velocity and the flow temperature, etc. There are many data sets.
And how have you dealt with zero values? Have you excluded them or filtered them by some conditions?
I'm sorry?
How have you dealt with zero values and input data or missing values or nil values? Were there any of them? Have you excluded them or filtered them in any way?
I'm sorry, I don't understand your questions.
So how you approach zeros or unknown values in your data sets?
We used value zero, yeah.
But did you process zeros or just skip them?
Sorry.
Okay. Zero or missed or omitted values can cause some problems. How do you handle zeros and missed values? Lost values.
If there is the error of the prediction testing training is close to the zero value, it is better, I think.
More questions, please. I would like to have one more question myself. So you conclude with a claim that multi-layer perceptrons are very good for classification problem. It is also quite well known that convolution networks are very good for image processing. I believe it is correct, right?
For image processing.
Where for what type of problems other types of neural networks will be better than perceptrons, multi-layer perceptrons, and better than convolution networks? Can you give example of a problem or a class of problems where neither convolution networks nor multi-layer perceptron will be good? Do you understand my question?
Yes. You want to know the types of network or
Which will be better for special class of problem, but which is neither convolution nor perceptron.
Modulia perceptron, yeah, modulia perceptron using activation, many activation function is better than perceptron, yeah.
Okay, so more questions, please. If no more questions, let's thank our speaker. Thank you very much. And we have the very, very, very last talk. Once again, sorry for, well, for changing the order, but is Evgenia Rezidinova available? Is you online? Or maybe Anatoly Sergeyev can make presentation.
Yes, Rezidinova is sick and I will give a report.
Why you did not say it earlier? Because, well, I simply just use information available in the program. Okay, so nice. Sorry for change of the order. Sorry about this. So Anatoly Sergeyev is going to present the last talk, and I'm sorry that I made change in the, against the program. Developing of training program by the method of interval repetition. You are also from Petersburg Polytechnical University, are you, right?
Yes.
Great. Please, dear, please show your screen, share your screen, please.
I don't.
I see.
This presenter did not switch.
Yes, Wa-Ong, please turn off your presentation.
Okay.
Please let us to share. Please let next presenter to share his screen.
We can't. Quick. Okay.
Okay, great. Yes, I see it. You start with results.
Good afternoon, dear colleagues. Let me present you with a talk on developing a training program with an interval repetition method. The work was done at the Polytechnic University. In the modern world, due to rapidly development of new technologies, people spend more time for learning. Both children and adults are studying.
Sorry, we don't see right part of your screen. It is covered by Zoom pictures. Please close it.
Sorry, I was not sure that it is only my problem, but indeed, your presentation is covered by some rectangles. Could you please restart?
It is Zoom. It is effect of Zoom. You see our faces, and they are not shown to us.
I see.
Share not the full screen, but one application.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, Andrei, it seems to me that again the same problem. Maybe you should try to proceed with not full screen, but just with
share just the screen of application, not the full screen. When choosing what to share, you see either to share the full screen or particular application.
Please go to.
It seems okay now.
Not here in Zoom.
It is okay. Please proceed with this mode. It will be much better.
Yes.
Than to continue experiments.
Mm-hmm. I go. Both children in this regard various technologies which reduce training time and facility training gain real advance. For many people, it is quite difficult to memorize a large amount of information because that cannot be memorized using only logical memory. People use mechanical memory to memorize foreign words, as well as to remember various terms, historical dates, rules, definitions. Dememorization mechanism when using logical and mechanical memory is quite different. For better memorization when using mechanical memory, it is necessary to periodically repeat the memorized information at regular intervals. To facilitate and partially automate the memorization and repetition procedure, it is advisable to use a special training program. As a result of using such a program, the learning speed and the reliability of memorization new information increase. Let us condition programs for memorizing words and expressions using interval repetition. One of oldest programs is Anki. The basic principle of operation is that user select a set of words to memorize. Program shows word and translation. Number of words varies from training to training. The repetition interval increases according to the methodology. 1 minute, 10 minutes, 1 day, 4 days, etc. Disadvantage of program are lack of training reminders and inconvenient program interface. When using this program during training, all interface element remain in place, which adversely affects the work. There is also no API for accessing data about user work in application. Another memory program is Memrise. Memrise is positioned as a service for learning foreign languages. Site works only online. There is practically no interactive components in it. There is no possibility to create your own cards. And there is not support the working which interval repetition technique. Quite interesting is Mnemosyne program, which uses interval repetition method and it is free. This is the research project of nature of long-term memory. Mnemosyne is as easy to use program. Mnemosyne uses a sophisticated algorithm to optimize the memorization process. At the request of user, anonymous statistics of education process can be uploaded to central server for analysis. This data is used to study memory behavior over a very long period of time. Results will be used to future improve algorithms and software. However, user interface is not optimized, as that program is only available on desktop systems. For memorizing information using mechanical memory, the interval repetition method is the best way. The technique should ensure the preservation of knowledge in long-term memory. The key to technique is systematic reproduction of information. The program should control the repetition intervals and provide the convenient access to material to minimize the time spent by the user on reproducing the recording knowledge. This slide shows the requirements for the system being developed. System should consist of several components: user application, web service for collecting, processing, and sending data about application usage to storage, web service for centralized processing and collecting data, public web API for providing anonymous data for learning. User application must be mobile oriented and run on both popular mobile platforms, iOS and Android. Application should provide to user the following features: grid flashcard with information to remember, train cards that is repeat the contents of card at regular intervals, tracking the degree of memorization card, start time of next word out, amount of card study. Application should automate following stages of learning process: creation card with information, saving a card with information, selecting a study card, planning your next workout, tracking progress of studying card, reminder to start training. Application need following conditions: application will work without an internet connection, safeguards and study progress when application is uninstalling and reinstalling, provide the same functionality for both platforms, iOS and Android. Web service for collecting data on user of application needs the following condition: work flawlessly with incomplete data, conduct primary data processing, checking, formatting, and depersonalization. The process of storing information by the method of interval repetition is shown in this slide. Training begins with processing of studied information. Cards are created with information containing a question, an answer, time of first training session. These cards are replaced in corresponding books or filing cabinet. Next, there is an expectation of training. When in comes time to train, cards that need to be trained at the given time are selected. Question cards are presented to user. User gives an answer. Correctness of the answer is checked. The trained result are recorded in training log. If a question in card was answered correctly, a certain amount of times card is removed from card index and is not used in for repetition in future. The rest of the cards are returned to the filing cabinet. In process of designing a custom application module, the MVC architecture was chosen. The MVC architecture present on this slide. This architecture shown used to divide the application into three parts: module, view, and controller. Module is a part of the architecture that is responsibility for application logic, storing and processing data. View is a part of the architecture responsibility for providing user bits and interface, to internal, to interact with application, as well as putting data. In this case, the same data can be presented to user in different views. Controller is piece of architecture that handles users read requests. Requests are any user actions that trigger the triggering of handler methods that refer to models. In this case, user actions are called events. The minimal version of this architecture is shown on this slide and includes following set of components. Actions include event, dispatcher, and handler entities, storage views. Action consists of three entities. Event is a notification about an event that has occurred contains an event identifier. Dispatcher is an event manager that calls a proprietary handler for each of them and transfers processing result to storage. A handler is a component that processes data from the repository according to a certain algorithm. Store is a storage component, and it is only a data source that provides information about the current state of a model. This data is used to represent state of model. Card module consists of card class and interface of accessing it. System allows the user to create cards, edit them, increase or reset the degree of memorization, delete from database, and view the general list of cards. System also automatically indicates the time of card creation and assigns the time of the next workout according to the methodology. Training module deals with training process. Training module consists of a workload class describing its current state, including meta information about amount of cards and the time spent. Within the framework of module is the training process take place, is answer of questions and answers to user and storage on the training results. Notification module schedules and sends notification to user about need for training. It is consist of a query of notification. And this module stores necessary data such as title and body for notification, as well as event handlers for the transition on the notifications to the application. For this system, the database model was designed. A relation database was chosen because it needs to maintain relations between process objects parameters in database. More details. Data schema is presented on this slide. Interval repetition training program was developed. This slide shows examples of the interfaces. This program implements only the client part of the developed application The developed program was tested. 6 copies of this program were distributed to people learning a foreign language. The testing showed the effectiveness of the program. The testing also confirmed the effectiveness of the interval repetition method for learning foreign words. According to subjective feelings of the testers, the memorization of foreign words became faster. The developed program made it possible to observe the required repetition intervals, as well to optimize the memorization process. Words that can be memorized quickly take less time, and words that are harder to memorize and repeated more often. Implementation and testing of the server part of the application is expected in the future. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much for your presentation. Sorry once again for swapping your turn with the last talk, but it is time for questions. Any questions, please?
Yeah. I have a question about adaptation of your system for some personal capability. Somebody could memorize faster, somebody know how to adopt your tools for the performance, for personal specifics.
Questions. Foreign words repeat one moment, please. Значит, the words can repeat quickly and fast when a word is
If you like, you could answer in Russian to my understanding.
Спасибо, да. Я английский, к сожалению, не очень хорошо. Значит, там принцип достаточно простой. Каждое слово надо правильно назвать определенное количество раз подряд. Вот. И если вы слово легко запоминаете, ну или определение, то, соответственно, вы называете его несколько раз подряд правильно, и, соответственно, оно удаляется из картотеки и больше не используется в повторении. А те слова, с которыми вы ошибаетесь, или там определения, даты, они повторяются еще раз, передаются на повторение, они еще раз спрашиваются. В результате те слова, которые легко запоминаются, они в общем-то, их спрашивают не так часто, а те слова, которые запоминаются реже, они спрашиваются чаще. И там есть интервалы, разные интервалы повторения, то есть сначала повторяются слова часто, там через 1 час, через 4 часа, Вот. А потом повторение может быть реже, через несколько дней. Вот те слова, которые вроде бы уже запомнились, они все равно повторяются, но уже реже. И в результате, если они забылись, то они снова переходят в разряд часто повторяемых. Если они помнятся, то значит, они уже запомнились, и все. Да. И в дальнейшем они не повторяются.
Понятно. Спасибо, спасибо. Отлично.
Можно вопрос? Еще? Да, пожалуйста.
Спасибо. А было ли это опубликовано в магазине приложения каком-нибудь?
Это, в общем-то, работа, она, еще, так сказать, почти подошла к концу. Еще серверное приложение отсутствует. И, в общем-то, в магазине приложений пока не опубликовали, хотя такие вот идеи есть. Но вот там есть вот одно из требований, чтобы, в общем-то, с одной стороны, данные передавались на сервер, вот, ну, для дальнейшего изучения, использования в случае необходимости. А с другой стороны, эти данные можно будет в дальнейшем использовать пользователям, который вот по каким-то причинам удалил приложение, потом захотел его восстановить, и вот у него уже информация о том, как процесс его обучения шел, она сохранялась на сервере. Вот. И обращаю ваше внимание, что эта информация анонимизирована, то есть там это просто какие-то данные сохраняются, кому они принадлежат, то это, в общем-то, не сохраняется.
То есть персональные данные утечки невозможны?
Нет, 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 программа это не предусматривает.
Не предусматривает и невозможны разные вещи, да?
Вот вы знаете, совершенно верно, это разные вещи, и тут вот, как сказать, гарантии, вот если так в общем говорить о том, что что-то даст гарантии, что какая-то программа не будет красть персональные данные, это гарантии сложно дать. То есть я могу гарантировать, что программа, над которой мы работали, она это не делает. Но вот что касается других программ, в принципе, такая возможность существует.
А еще короткий вопрос. Я правильно понял, что тестировалось только на английском языке? Будет ли тестироваться на каких-то других языках, возможно, на обучение иностранцев русскому языку? Спасибо.
Вот на этот вопрос я ответить не могу, потому что, к сожалению, хотелось бы, но вот насколько пойдет в дальнейшем процесс развития этой программы, я не могу сказать.
Ладно, хорошо, спасибо.
Возможно, для самого последнего, самого короткого вопроса. Вопросов больше нет. Спасибо, thank you very much. I believe thank that I should switch turn to one of Alexander. Either Alexander Petrenko or Alexander Kamkin. Please decide yourself. Ага, Александр Константинович Петренко. Окей.
Что тут микрофон? Сиди здесь.
Окей. So, dear colleagues, it's my pleasure to see everybody. It seems some rare possibility. To see our colleagues from abroad, from other Russian cities. Many thanks to all participants and, of course, all organizations, and basically to Alexander Kamkin. He is the main motor of this conference, at least this year, maybe not only this year, but several past years. So, in fact, maybe it's some surprise for me, a program of our conference this year was very interesting. Both invited talks and regular talks was very informative. and was good presentation and all talks that could I saw were very, very interesting. I hope not only for me. Okay. So now we should start process for preparation of final version of papers. So if everybody can like to improve presentation of your papers, please send to us. And I hope during June we will send these papers to our journals. We, as you know, we have, we publish two journals, Proceeding of ESPRAS and Journal Programming and Computer Software. Yeah. So your papers, if they were accepted as regular papers, will be published in these journals, and this will be good results for both for you and for us. I hope next year we could held this conference in the regular format. So remote and hybrid formats, not good for me at least. of course, face-to-face discussion, talk and communications, very important part, not only of research work, but our life as a whole. So it's, and I hope next year will be better from this point of view. I'm invited to participate in ESPRAS conference during autumn. So we will conduct at least two conference, Ivanikov workshop in the beginning of autumn, and ESPRAS open conference at the beginning of December. So you have time to prepare papers, and please reserve time for participation in this conference, and I hope this conference will be conducted in your usual traditional format. So could you say something in conclusion? Everybody, Nikolai, please. Yeah,
I would like to thank all organizers, because indeed you are very right. Very interesting invited talks and talks that I attended. Thank you very much for you, for Alexander Kamkin, for all program committee members. And thank you for continuous work on this conference. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes, and few words. I would like to thank PC members also, and I would like to thank, of course, participants and moderators of the sessions. So thank you very much.
Okay. So
thank you, everybody. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.